So today I thought I would show you how I highlight and contour my face, and if you want to see how I made this look, keep watching. First, I apply a primer from MAC in the color Radiant Yellow, and I apply it like I just would with a regular cream. Just breathe against the glass. Leave me some kind of sign. I know the hurt won't pass, yeah. For foundation, I use the Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the color 120. And I use the foundation brush from the Body Shop to apply it all over my face, starting from the bottom and working it upwards. Now I take my damp beauty blender and I tap it lightly on my skin to blend out the foundation. You drew a question mark, but you know what I want. I wanna turn the clock, yeah. So now I take my concealer from MAC in the color NC15 and I apply it underneath my eyes to hide any dark circles or any puffiness, and then I apply a little bit on my nose, on my chin, and on my forehead. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. We can't be looking like this, so I'm taking my Micro Beauty Blender and I tap it lightly on my skin to blend out all the concealer. To set my concealer and prevent it from creasing, I am using a method called baking, and that's where I use a translucent powder to apply it wherever I applied my concealer, and I just leave it there for about 5 to 10 minutes. While I'm waiting for my concealer to set, I am going to do my brows real quick. After 5 to 10 minutes, you can just brush away the excess powder and just keep on going with the other makeup. For contouring, I'm using a face paint brush from Zoeva, and I'm using the contour kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I use the middle brown color for that. When I contour, I like to follow the line from the tip of my ear and to the tip of my mouth, and I just follow that line when I contour. So now I take my brush and I just kind of wiggle it back and forth underneath my cheekbones to just create a little bit of shadow, but not too much. Of course, if you're going for a more dramatic look, you would want to put on a little bit more than I just did. And to blend it out, I'm just wiggling my brush up and down. I know the hurt won't pass, yeah. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. I never meant to break your heart. And I won't let this plane go down. I never meant to make you cry. I'll do what it takes. I take a contour brush from Zoeva and I use the same color from the contour kit, and I just apply a little bit in my hairline to make my forehead appear a bit more smaller. You drew a question mark, but you know what I want. I want to take the lighter color from the kit and just apply it underneath where I apply my contour for my cheekbones to create a little bit more definition. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. Contouring my nose, I'm using the bronzing powder from the Balm, and what I do is I just draw a line on both sides of my nose, and I also drag it all the way up to my brow and also go around the tip to make it appear more narrow or smaller. Girl, I know we could climb back to where we were then. Feel it here in my heart, put my heart in your hand. Well, I hope and I pray that you do understand. If you did, all you have to say is yeah, 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 yeah. I'm waiting for ya. Yeah, 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 yeah. I never meant to break your. To blend out the contour lines, I'm just using my brush to kind of drag the color a bit more down to create more shadow, and for any harsh lines that might still be there, I'm just using my fingers to blend that out. So I take an eyeshadow crease brush from Zoeva, and I take the same color as I've used for my other contouring and I apply it in my crease to create more definition. I drew a broken heart right on your window pane. Waited for your reply. Here in the pouring rain. Just breathe it. So now I'm taking my Mary Luminizer from the Balm, and I use a highlighter brush to highlight my cheekbones and over my brow. And as you can see, I'm going in a C around my eye, like the letter C. So you can use that as a guideline for applying highlighter. For the areas that are too small to get to with a brush, I'm just using my finger to apply the highlight with. I am applying it to my nose and underneath my brow and over and also on my eyelid. So now I'm going back with an eyeshadow brush to put some highlight on my Cupid's bow and on my chin. So now I'm just applying some mascara. I use the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara, and in my opinion, this is the absolute best mascara because it won't make my lashes clumpy or stick together, so it just makes them look really natural. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. Just tell me it's not the end of the line. I never meant to break your heart. And I won't let this pain go down. I never meant to. So now I'm taking a tiny eyeshadow brush and I apply some highlighter on my lower lash line and also in my tear duct to create a more well-rested look. And of course we need some blush, so I'm using the Oriflame blush and just applying a little bit on my cheeks with a blush brush. So this is the final look, and of course for a nighttime look I would do it more dramatic and put some eyeshadow on, but for a day-to-day look, I think this is perfect and it looks natural. So yeah, thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed. I'll do what it takes to make this life. All you got.